Hey guys, welcome back for another episode. Today will be my new series of videos, which is titled Cooking with Epic Conspiracy. And today we will be cooking three cheese hamburger helper. It's cheap, it's good, awesome to cook, and I'll show you how to cook hamburger helper. Okay, the first thing we got to do is brown about a pound of meat. Put it in here. It's best if you like rip the meat apart like this. It browns much, much faster. Go wash my hands. Alright, you turn your stove on, about medium, I would say. I have a gas stove. I much prefer gas over electric. Any day, I'd take it over electric. And you let it cook. And I don't know, about every few minutes you want to come in and kind of cut it up a little bit more, move it around. All right, starting to brown pretty nice. The meat I'm using is 85% 15, so 15% fat. That's what I like to use. Let it sit like that for a couple more minutes. Give it a little bit more stir. Ooh. You have to kind of be careful because you can flip this just right on your stove and just make a big mess. Then the lady of the house will be upset. Just about done. I just see a little bit of red in the meat. Like when I cook steaks, I like my steaks rare. You know, I want my cow mooing when I eat it. But I'm a little weird when it comes to hamburgers. I like my hamburgers pretty well done. Doesn't make a lot of sense, but you know. Alright. Just looks pretty good. Okay, I think the hamburger meat is done. The next thing we have to do is drain the meat. All right, to drain the meat, you just get a strainer here, and you wanna pour it all in there. Get all the grease out if you can. Give it a couple shakes, is what I like to do. And then, pour the meat back in. The next thing you want to do, you need 2 cups of milk to get poured in a cup. So, just pour it in there, 2 cups. There's 2 cups of milk. And then you need to get 1 cup of very hot water. And then when you get a cup of water, you pour that in there. Make sure the water's really hot. It'll come out better at the end. Then after that, you put in the sauce mix.
that a little snip snip. This is the cheesy mix. Get it all out of there. Then the final component, you put in the pasta. And we got all that in there. Just stir it around. Then you wait for it to come to boiling before you head on to the next step. So just turn your heat up there and wait for it to boil. You do want to stir it like every minute or so just to make sure it doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan. I'm using a non-stick pan, but I just like to be safe than sorry. All right, stir that up, wait for it to boil. Okay, everybody, as you can see, it's boiling now. We got it up to a boil. Let's give it one more good stir. As it's starting to take shape. Oh, okay. And now what you do, lower it down to simmer. I always put mine just above simmer and cover. And then you want to set your kitchen timer to 15 minutes. And make sure you set it down close to simmer so you don't burn the shit out of it. Just cover it up, and then every, I don't know, 2-3 minutes, lift it up and stir. Okay, I'm about 5 minutes in. Whoa. Be careful lifting this up because a bunch of condensation builds up on the top of it and you'll spill it everywhere like I just did. All right, about 5 minutes in. Just gonna stir it up some here. Like the box says, just to cook it with the cover on for 14 minutes. I always do it a minute or two more. That's why I said 15 minutes. Just to make sure the pasta is nice and soft. All right. Place that back. And we'll wait a few more minutes. Okay, time is up, guys. What you're gonna wanna do is turn the stove off, take off the lid. Stir it up a little bit. Okay, and you're going to want to let it sit for a few minutes before you put it on your plate and serve it, because the sauce will thicken up after it sits for a couple minutes and it'll be presented much, much better, especially if you're cooking for anybody else. So we'll let that sit for now for 2 minutes while I get my plate and everything in order. And voila, there we have it. That's how I like to have it, served up with pepper, salt, 2 pieces of bread and butter, and some milk. And just took me maybe 25, 30 minutes to make this meal, and it's enough for probably 3 or 4. So there you have it. Hamburger helper a la carte. Make it, impress your friends. Have leftovers for lunch the next day, I don't know. Very simple meal. But until next time, watch out for the truth, because the truth is out there.